Hello everybody and welcome back to Farm Simulator 17 with me, the Great Gamer, and that's a wrap. No, we're not starting the episode by closing off the episode. But I did finish getting all the bales left, wrapped up. I took a stack of them over and put them over by the cow's trough. A stack of regular hay bales. No. Say it again. Regular grass bales. So we got that taken care of. Let's fold this up. Am I not on the right thing? No, I'm not. There we go. Fold that back up. And we can park this wrapper, bale wrapper, back in here. Put it right here. All right. So, what do we got to do still? The harvester, I think, is done. So let's move the harvester. Yeah, it's finished. Pipe in, and we'll just turn around and park it over here in the spot. There we go. Okay, we got this guy planting wheat, so we'll hire Phoenixon to finish that off. We've got Graktor working on that field over there planting soybeans. As you can see, I got the other straw bales there ready to go. So yeah, let me go pick up this last straw bale that's over here. And then we can start picking up those silage bales and pushing them in to get the power food going. Let's see, can I unload. Now, let me unload this one just so I don't mess up before I go pick up the other ones. Put this one right here somewhere. Again, the idea is as soon as I get this fully operational, which it is operational now, by the way, because I did push some silage in there. It's not full. Let's take a look at our numbers. Okay, as you can see here, 9,000. This is the one. Oh, it's pretty close though, 81,000. So I forgot that I had prepped that ahead of time over the weekend. Alright, so let's unload the bale. Back it up just a little bit. There we go. But like I said, the idea being we finally got some power food going, so we will definitely be giving that to the cows. I'm trying to figure out what button I'm supposed to push there. All right, let's go get a stack of silage. Whoops. Let's go get a stack of silage bales. And then we can push it in there and see how much it's going to take. It's probably not going to take a full stack, so I don't have to worry about that too much. Come on, pick it up. Yeah, you go. You know you want to. Well, yeah, we'll get these off of the field eventually, I think, but I'm not going to worry about it too much. In other words, if I don't have to come over here and mow for a while, that's okay with me. Because you spend a lot of time prepping this stuff, you know? If you guys play the game, you know what I'm talking about. So, but again, our goal is to see where we're at. That's not our goal is not to see where we're at. Our goal is to see we have 31 cows, 102 sheep. No, we have 25 sheep and 102 pigs. So, scroll this back up. And like I said, I'm going to take this over and unload it right in front, hopefully. But as you can see, we've got plenty of grass in the bunker. We've got plenty of silage in the bunker now. And we've got that forage wagon full. Plus, I still have loose straw over there in the barn building. So, all right, this is going to probably be edited depending on how well I do with this. I don't jackknife it too much. I'm trying to see. There we go. Put it right there. Not too bad. I didn't have to edit that too much. I want to make sure I'm putting it on the ground though, and not on the slope, so they don't go kitty womp. Stay up, stay up, stay up, stay up. There we go. Now wait till it folds completely up. There we go. Thank you. And then use this proven technique. Go. That topped it off. So let me go fill this back up one more time, rinse and repeat on this, and then we'll get going on some other stuff, meaning we'll get our other fields planted. Got quite a few bales, as you can see. We still have quite a few that we can be getting, so I think this is gonna pay off big time dividends for us. So park this up. Double check our cows again just to make sure everything is copacetic. Yeah, they're good on everything, grass, silage, water, everything. Same thing with the sheep. And I just need to get corn, wheat, and the potatoes up to the sheep, up to the pigs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and unload, or not unload, but park this here, kind of like on the parallel with the other one. And then gonna hook up to this tipper, and we're gonna take it up to the farm. But before I do that, I'm gonna switch over to the other tractor there and get trying to think and do and drive at the same time is not working today. There we go. Jump out and get in the other tractor here real quick. And let's get some scoops. Two scoops. Do I have anything in my bucket? No, I don't have anything in my bucket, so I'm good. Power food. And I just have to get on the other side of the Juno here and pull in. Oh yeah, that one hay bale there. That should disappear, I think, when they get low on straw. There we go. Power food. Let's give them at least one more scoop. Because I don't think it's going to be quite enough. But I definitely want this to be processing so that it's. See something here. Yeah, we got 17. In there. Did I not put my bucket down? Come on. There we go. So yeah, now we got 15 in there. So that's good. But like I said, we'll let that'll run for quite a while now. And the Juno's over there. So let me go right here. Okay, trying some in cab. Not the greatest at it. But give it a shot. All right, we'll leave this here for now. Lower the bucket down. Take the pressure off the hydraulics. There we go. All right, we're going to head up to the farm with this, and let's see, double check this. This is wheat and barley. This would probably go right to the pigs to get them topped off with that. I think I have another tipper up there that I bought and then didn't even, I only used like one time. So I'll have to check into that. It's another one like this one, but I got it red because I was going to use it for transporting stuff to the pigs. So I went with red, and then I'm not actually using it. So yeah, still got to plant all of this down here yet, my two cornfields, and then field 19 with the sunflowers. So we're going to take care of that as well. Plus I got to get my other tractor back down there at the cows, replanting that field in barley. So yeah, things are popping and hopping. Let me see if I've got any more in here I can take up. Fill this up if I can. There we go. Uh-oh, got weird growth going again. What happened this time? Did I speed it up somehow? By the way, you can see that I did away with the conveyor belts altogether, and I've been using the skid steer to load the tipper in there. So, all right, let me see what's going on with my workers. Little strip. This is the soybeans. I think that's soybeans over there as well. So this is the tractor that's going to go to the down below to do the sunflowers. So let's go switch it over to sunflowers. And we'll get him going on that other field. Oh, I see what's happening. It's getting on to the middle of the day, almost night. Okay, so we want to go. Why did I do that? Why did I make a big loop there? I don't know. I don't know, but we're going to put sunflowers on this field like we've been doing, and corn on both of those fields down below there, fields 23 and 24. What am I doing? Seriously? I honestly do not know, folks. And it's not even like I'm recording this in the middle of the night. I actually slept through the night pretty good. And it's now 7:30 in the morning. Granted, I haven't had my morning coffee yet, but hey, that might be something. Might be a thing. Okay, we got the same situation going on over here. So let me lower that down and run him along the strip. And this is wheat. And again, we're using this for the straw for the pigs. And obviously food for the pigs as well. So I think I'm not going to sell pigs for a while if I can help it. I mean, if I get really desperate for money, I will. But let's go a few episodes before we sell any pigs. Okay, got that done. Park him up. And then what I'll probably do is I'll have to speed up time again to get through the night. Plus I need to double check my percentages at the midnight hour to see if I'm covering my expenses or not. Because I want to make sure that the greenhouses are bringing in the income that they're supposed to be bringing in. And of course the milk, covering the cost of the vehicle maintenance and stuff. That's another reason why I want to check to see if I still got that tipper up here, because obviously I don't want an extra tipper if I don't really need it. I bought it because I tried a different maneuver with the conveyor belts, and I thought with the smaller tipper, it's one just like this, that I could get it to nudge over the top and fill it up with a conveyor belt, but it didn't work. Yeah, there it is over there, the red one. So we want to get rid of that, sell that, and let's see if I can pull in here without bumping the Juno. Unload. Uh-oh, Juno's gonna get bumped anyway. Oh, made it out. Made it out just in time. Alright, so that means that pig should be good on wheat and barley. So now it's just the corn and soybeans, sunflowers, canola. Alright, plus the potatoes. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to take this back down and put it back in the bunker. First of all, let's go to our garage. And let me sell. Go through here. I probably should sell that thing too, because that really doesn't do me any good. Not using it. Okay, now which one of these do I sell? Boy, you know what? I'm not going to take a chance because I don't want to sell one of them and then it'd be the one that has the grain in it. So let me take this down to the silo. Oh man, I'm thinking this through. I'm trying to think it through. Take this to the silo. I'll probably come back up in the middle of the night, grab that other tipper, drive it down, and sell it directly. That way I make sure that it's the one that I want to sell and not this one. I want to keep the yellow one because, well, it goes with the harvester down there at the cow farm. All right, let me go ahead and bump up my time and go through the night here. Yikes. Wage pigments. Oh, I'm doing it again though. Turn the time back down. Wait until you get the fields planted. Ding ding. Yeah, that's true, I should. Alright, let me go over here real quick. I just want to see. I don't think I do have any corn left, but let me look just to see. We've got a little bit of wheat, some barley, canola, sunflowers, soybean, no corn. Okay, but we needed up at the pigs. We need some canola. We need some of the protein and some of the root crop. Okay. So let's go ahead and take our skid steer. Look with our skid steer here, and we'll fill up this with the mixture. That'll take care of the potatoes and the protein crop that they need. Might not fill it completely up, but at least partially so. And the skid steer bucket is nice, so, because it holds a lot more than the other one. Oh, I didn't look to see how much power food we got going on at the cows. Not a whole lot, but we're at 100% production all the way across the board, folks. Sheep, pigs, and cows are at 100% production. It's a red letter day. Don't know exactly what that's supposed to mean. I remember people saying it back in the day about red being a red letter day. But as you can see, even with a pretty good sized bucket, I already had some in there, and it takes quite a few scoops to fill this up, which I'm not going to do on screen. In fact, I'm going to change my plan altogether. I'm going to get one more scoop. And then I'm going to transport this up to the pigs with my other tractor. And then I'm going to grab that other tipper while it's up there. The one that's up there, and take it to the market. Yeah. Whoops. Oh no, don't spill it on the ground now, Greg. Come on. Even though the graphic shows it going on the ground anyway. Alright, let me get this out of the way. Not the most exciting episode, I can tell you, for even from my perspective. But I do appreciate you guys taking the time to watch. Okay, why'd you miss a whole section over there next to you there, bro? I'm gonna grab this, transport this to the piglets. At least that's my plan. And then, like I said, I'll leave this one up above. And I hope this thing has got more power than the Maggie. The one that we traded in for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode here. So thank you for guys for stopping by and checking me out. I do appreciate it. If you enjoy the videos, give it a thumbs up. Tell your friends that the Great Gamer is back and going strong, so I can get some of my subscriber base back. And I appreciate it. I really do appreciate it. If you have any thoughts or suggestions, let me know. If you come up with if you know of a mod that you think I could use, let me know. Not trying to put any guilt trip on a certain friend of mine who used to do mod spotlights that I would use most of the mods that he would spotlight. Caretivers. But now I don't have that source. I know other people do mod spotlights as well. So Carver76 does some, and Ian Robson has done some. So yeah, we will see you guys tomorrow. Get out of the way. Made it.